The experiment is a determination of dipole moment. For this we are going to Avogadro software. In Avogadro software, we are unselecting adjust hydrogen. Then we are going to bond order. We are going to element. In element, we are going for other, so that we get our zinc. We are placing our zinc atoms. We have 3 zinc atoms and 3 oxygen atoms. Okay. Oxygen comes here. Whenever we do a mistake, we should give a control check. So we are placing our oxygen atoms in the places we require. One of your we are forming the bond. So our bond is formed with 3 zinc atoms and 3 oxygen atoms. Now we are going to extensions, molecular mechanics, setup force field. In force field we are giving UFF, and for number of steps it is 5000, and for convergence it will be 10^-9, and we are giving K. Then we go for extension once again, and we will optimize the geometry. Then we go for extension and move back. We are giving the title 3 D3B
H
D3H. B3H. Yeah, Jeremy is always right because I trained her last year. B3H. And we are going to generate. We are choosing the location. It is in desktop batch 3. The extension will be .mov and the file name is B3H. And we are saving it. We are closing this. We don't want to close this. Just minimize this. Now we go to batch 3. And the file is D3H. It is here. We are opening the file in a notepad. Here, instead of this command, our command would be charges, charges, charges. We are saving this file and we are running it. So once it runs, we will have d3h.log such files. Once again, we open this file in notepad. Instead of charges, we give
charge.
We have to see what is the charge. We go to d3h out so that we get to know the charge. We scroll it down. Computed charge on system is -6. We have to note this in our mind. Then we go to d3h.mop file. Open it with notepad. Instead of charges, we give let charge equal to -6. Is equal to 10. Cut down.
Save.
Now we are saving this file. We are saving this file. Then we have to save and run this file. once we run it, we get the R file. We have to open the R file now.
Open
the R file in Notepad. Open with Notepad. So we have opened it, and now we have to go to the final geometry obtained. Here we are till aux we have to delete, and instead of that we have to type polar. We have to save this. After saving this, we have to run the R file. Looks like this. It's not needed. Then one thing is created. D3H.pol is created. Now we have to find the. We have to open the output file. In the output file, we just scroll down to see the timeline. Something is wrong, I think, because energy here it is, and we minus Lumo minus Momo. We get the band gap energy, and scrolling down, we could find the dipole moment. The total sum is the dipole moment, and by scrolling down, we could see the isotropic average alpha. This value will be the alpha value. Thank you.